Hi, this is Amin from the Glass team, and I'm going to show you how to create voice-driven GDK Glassware. I'll show you the available APIs and how to use each of them. First, let's demonstrate how to get directions on Glass using Google Maps.
Okay, Glass, get directions to San Francisco. Okay, Glass, show route overview.
This Glassware uses two voice APIs. First, the voice trigger API links the get directions to voice command to the Google Maps navigation activity. Second, the contextual voice menu API defines a custom OK Glass menu within this activity. Let's dive deeper into both of these APIs. To launch your Glassware from the voice main menu, the first thing you need to do is define a voice trigger XML file. This trigger specifies which command launches your Glassware, what constraints your activity requires, as well as whether your Glassware needs open-ended voice input. Here, navigationTrigger.xml uses the getDirectionsToCommand, requires a network connection, and needs open-ended voice input when launching. Next, you'll need to refer to this voice trigger in the activity definition of your Android manifest file. Here's the Android manifest for the Google Maps navigation Glassware. You can see that the navigation activity references the navigation trigger resource we just defined in its metadata section. And that's it. The next time you install your APK, you'll be able to launch your Glassware from both the voice and touch main menus from the home screen. Now we'll move on to contextual voice menus. Adding this menu to your activity is straightforward, especially if you are familiar with how Android menus work. The in-app OK Glass menu is a window feature. When you request this window feature, the Glass platform takes care of enabling voice recognition and showing the OK Glass guard phrase on the screen. When voice commands are triggered, the platform then calls menu-specific methods on your activity. Just like standard Android menus, voice menus can also be inflated from XML. Here, navigation trigger activity inflates the voice menu XML in onCreatePanelMenu and then handles voice commands in onMenu item selected. In addition to these two Glass-specific APIs, GDK Glassware can also use the Recognizer Intent and Speech Recognizer APIs from the Android SDK to collect open-ended voice input from the user at any time. With Recognizer Intent, you can launch an activity in the Glass platform that prompts the user for open-ended input. This activity will look and feel just like other open-ended UIs you've seen on Glass. Here, main activity launches a recognizer intent and then processes the recognized text in onActivity result. If you want even more control over voice input, you can work directly with the voice recognition service via the speech recognizer API. Your Glassware can define a recognition listener that will receive transcription results in real time while the user is speaking. Here, main activity creates a speech recognizer and implements some of the callback methods of recognition listener. With these Android APIs allowing fine-grained control over voice input, along with the Glass-specific invocation and contextual APIs, you can create a compelling, voice-driven experience to power your GDK Glassware. To find out more, make sure to visit our website and check out the Google Developers YouTube channel for more Glass videos. Thank you for watching.